In this lecture series of the Physiology Meet Easy, I will discuss about cardiac action potential and I will explain about diastolic potential. Now, as we know very well, the membrane potential is depend upon the permeability of the ions in the cardiac muscle. It depends upon the sodium ion and potassium ion. No doubt it is more depend upon the potassium ions. Permeability of the other ions are minor and often ignored. But in case of the cardiac muscle, the calcium ions participate in cardiac muscle action potential and play important role in producing plateau phase of action potential. So we must know the equilibrium potential for the calcium is plus 100 millivolt, and when it reaches, the permeability of calcium ion is now. So the under the resting condition, the membrane potential is quite close to the potassium equilibrium potential, and at this point, slow leak of the sodium and calcium ion, they enter into the cell. Because of the leak, slow leak in comparison to the potassium, and ultimately destroy the transmembrane. Next slide. In this slide, the cardiac muscle action potential, we have to discuss in two types of the cardiac myocytes. Because it is of two types, cardiac muscles are of two types. One is the specialized conduction system and another is ventricular cardiac muscle. So, in a specialized conduction system, also include the pacemaker, just like sinoatrial node. So, act as a pacemaker and spontaneous initiate action potential. And this type of the action potential is slow response action potential. While in typical ventricular cardiac muscle, it is fast type or fast response action potential. So we will discuss two types of action potential in cardiac muscles. One is the slow response and another is. Now we will take one by one. For fast response action potential is characterized by the curve in this fashion. Means you will have phase 4 first, then phase 0. Phase 0 is a depolarization phase. Then phase 1. Initial repolarization and followed by plateau phase 2. This is followed by repolarization phase, that is phase 3. And after the phase 3, no doubt phase 4 will come, and this is because of resting membrane potential. The fast response action potential, you will find the depolarization phase occur. Acute depolarization phase, or the curve you will find here, the straight line. In slow response action potential, phase 4, or you can say phase 4 depolarization, another name is diastolic repolarization, or another name is pacemaker potential. Why we call pacemaker potential? It occurs in SA node, AV node, in normal heart. And SA node, no doubt, phase 4 depolarization means after the phase 4 depolarization occur. And diastolic depolarization means after the diastole there is a depolarization. And slope is in this phase. So slow response characterized by slower initial depolarization phase, this one. Lower amplitude. Just above the, at the level of zero. Shorter and less stable plateau phase. Repolarization phase unstable. And slowly depolarizing resting membrane potential. So you will find unstable, slowly depolarizing resting membrane potential. In the first phase, in the fast response, you will find a resting membrane potential just like in the scalp muscle and nerve. Here you will find it is unstable and slowly depolarizing resting membrane potential. So slow depolarization and gradual increase in sodium potassium permeability ratio. Slow depolarization causes are three. There are three main causes. Number one, first, there is a decrease in membrane permeability to potassium ion during the resting phase. First, that membrane becomes less permeability for potassium ions. Second, permeability to sodium ion increases slowly. So what will happen? The gradient between the sodium potassium because of the permeability ratio is now maintained or increased gradually. So it is now from membrane equilibrium potential for potassium is now suppose minus 90, it becomes towards the positive side. So in slow depolarization, it is minus 55 and it reaches to the minus 50. Now what is the reason of, you can say, the specific current that occurred during the diastole? What happens that the third cause is slight increase in the permeability or the movement of the positively charged calcium ions contribute diastolic depolarization. And this is called funny current because it is not very much only specific for cardiac muscles. And this is a specific current that occurs during diastole. That's why it is called funny current. So once we go through this chapter or lecture, then we will label the given picture. And in this picture, there are 10 marked red in color. And each arrow or each mark carries one mark. So there total are 10 marks. And you can assess yourself how much you know. But to explain it, now I will explain it and you can judge how much we know. This is for potassium ion. This is star. This moon phase is for sodium ion. This rocket ship it is calcium ions. One more, this is due to the L channel. One more is the T channel, T type of channel. So you will find the permeability decreases for potassium, increases for calcium and sodium. So it becomes more positive. After that, there is no role of the sodium ions, only the role of the calcium ions. And after the initiation of action potential, calcium L channels, L type of the channels, they activate. So more entry of the calcium and up to this phase. So rising is slow, not very acute or very steep, but you will find it is slow rising of action potential. Or you can say slow depolarization. At the peak of this, you will find the permeability of the potassium ions is initiated. And inactivation start from this point to the resting membrane potential. Here you will find inactivation is going on decreasing. Here is more entry, decreasing the entry of the calcium ions. And exit or efflux of the potassium ion continues. This continues beyond this phase, beyond the resting membrane potential. So this is repolarization and this is called hyperpolarization because of the potassium ion continues to go out. Now at this point, there is more entry of the calcium and more, what will happen? Slight amount of the sodium and the calcium ions T type through the T type channels, and which will be responsible for slope of the, or you can say, unstable diastolic. So we will find there is a little bit difference between the slow response and the fast response action potential. Here it is not, it is a stable resting memory potential. While in slow, you will find a slope. It is not a stable. Second, you will, here you will find phase 0 is a steep. It is not very steep. It is a, it is just like this. Third, you will find plateau phase is long, but here you will find very short or absent. In this phase, you will find repolarization is slow, but it is not very slow. And it converted into hyperpolarization in slow phase, but not here. So we will conclude again in ionic terms that the changes in external potassium concentration affect the resting memory potential or the cardiac muscle. Now this is important in medicine also, in an applied condition also. So external potassium concentration affect your potential of resting membrane potential, while the external sodium concentration affect the magnitude of action potential. Now, what are the ionic changes occur in different phases of acute response? Initial rapid depolarization and offshoot as in phase 0 is due to the voltage-gated sodium channels. Initial rapid repolarization phase 1 is due to the closure of the sodium channels and opening of the one type of the potassium channel. And then it will close gradually. So initial rapid repolarization is due to the inactivation of sodium channels. Plateau is due to opening of voltage-gated calcium channels, which are slow to open but prolonged to stay. Final repolarization up to the resting membrane potential is due to the closure of the calcium channels and delayed increase of sodium efflux through the various type of the potassium channels. So you will find that these plateau, for the plateau, calcium ions play important role. So there are two types of the channels for the calcium, T type and the L type. Calcium current is usually due to the opening of slower L type, longitudinal type calcium channels. Now the fast response of the action potential because of fast inward current of the sodium, but it is for short-lived. And potassium permeability increases after the peak of action potential. Fast response action potential, we will find why there is a development of prolonged depolarized plateau state. There are two conditions, two separate processes for that. One is the sustained reduction in the potassium permeability. Second, sustained increase in the membrane's permeability to calcium ions. Now, here in the plateau, one more very, very important, that the sodium-calcium exchanger, which play important role and in which three sodium ions move into the cell in exchange for the single calcium ion which move out of the cell and which maintain condition. So there are three things you must remember. Sustained sodium channel inactivation means this sodium channel closes, and activation of calcium channel and opening of potassium channels responsible for plateau phase and long cardiac point refractory period. Now we can compare the two curves, resting membrane potential, then phase 0. Here there is no phase 0 like that. This is slow. Flat 2 absent here. Phase 3 is again just like a depolarization phase. No hyperpolarization here. Here you will find the hyperpolarization. So what are the causes of slow diastolic depolarization? Inactivating H gates of many of the fast sodium channels to close before threshold is reached. Why we call H gate? Because that in the face of hyperpolarization, these sodium channels gate are closed. So the fast sodium channel, the cells are initially not able to open at once and they are inactivated. So this resting membrane potential we will find in pacemaker, and there is a resultant rising phase is slow. After the repolarization, hyperpolarization is occurred due to the activated HCN channels. And this channel is activated at the end of repolarization phase, promote slow entry of the sodium, potassium and calcium. So gradually it depolarizes the cells during diastole. That is why diastolic depolarization. So slow diastolic depolarization by the funny current due to cyclic nucleotide gated SCN channel activated. So if we know the slow diastolic depolarization, we find the SCN channel, they get activated.